Hi everyone, Tabitha here, and what I want to do today is welcome you to our Let's Learn series, where we learn and talk about a specific topic and feature related to ActiveCampaign. Today what our focus is going to be is campaigns. We're going to walk through a couple things to introduce you to our example business, what campaigns is, some best practices, why you'd want to use campaigns over automations, and then we'll dive into the platform to build our first campaign together. Let's go ahead and get started. Our example business today is going to be reflective of an e-commerce business that sells products for dogs. They're hosted on Shopify and they connect through our deep data integration where all of their data comes over to let us know about purchasing and customer usage. We're also using tools in the platform like automations, campaigns, CRM, and the forms builder. Today, though, what we want to focus on specifically is how Boone's Bandanas uses campaigns. So, what are campaigns? Campaigns allow you to send messages to your contacts, whether it be through a one-time send or a series of messages through automations. You have an opportunity in campaigns to really think about the different ways in which you want to communicate with your contacts. We'll talk a lot about the CXA messaging that you can build, which is right message, right time, right person, right medium, and you can start doing that through your campaigns. Today, in our example, what we'll focus on is our standard campaign, but just note there are six different types of campaigns. Your automated type of campaign will take you straight to the automation builder. Your autoresponder is something that will trigger as soon as somebody subscribes to a list. Your date-based trigger will also trigger when somebody actually meets the condition of a date that they've given you versus the date that it is within your campaign. A campaign will automatically go out to that contact based on the date meeting criteria. RSS triggered is for if you're a blogger. And split testing is a great way to test different campaigns against each other to see what is performing better and to get the best idea of how your contacts are responding to your campaigns. Now, let's talk through some email best practices. As you're starting to build your campaigns, all of these things are going to be really crucial in laying the foundations for successful campaigns. First, sending highly segmented targeted emails. We talk a lot, again, about that CXA messaging, how you want to send the right message to the right person. Using segmentation and the data that you have on your contacts will allow you to start in a really good spot to getting contacts the emails that they're looking for. Think about your template style. How are you communicating with your contacts? What is the different kinds of languages that you're using within your business? Your templates should reflect not only your branding, but the ways that in which you are communicating with your contacts. Using personalization tags, which are directly related to your custom fields, will give you an opportunity to take a one-to-many message and make it feel very personalized and one-to-one. Your contacts can start to respond to that because they'll feel as though the message was intended specifically for them. Now, using catchy pre-header text and subject lines is going to be the best way to get contacts or customers to open your emails. They don't know that you've created a ton of great content inside of your campaigns until they're persuaded to open it. Your pre-header text is sort of like the cliff notes of your email, giving your contacts an idea of what the email is going to be about. Arguably, having a call to action might be the most important thing that you can do. Think about all of the different reasons which you're creating this campaign. What is the goal that you're looking for your contact to achieve in this campaign? And create your call to action around it. Your call to action is not only going to be driving them outside of your campaign, quite possibly to your website, but it is also going to trigger the cookie on the contact. So it is definitely a multi-purpose button to have within your campaigns. Now, you can absolutely track your email performance through our campaign reporting and the different things that we can track for you to show you how you're being successful with in your campaigns. That's going to be super important as you start to develop more campaigns and want to see where you're having your successes or where you may need to refocus. Now, you may have a question, what is the difference between campaigns and automations? And I'm here to help you understand why you would use one over the other or what situation you might need to build. Campaigns are really good for one-time sends. If you're sending a newsletter blast, let's say a quarterly announcement from your business, you have a new product line. Maybe since it's a new season, you have a different line coming out, or you're having a sale on your previous season. Things that you're sending in bulk as a one-time message to a larger group of your contacts. Also, split testing in campaigns is really successful as you get specific data and reporting of which campaigns were the most successful and allowing you to resend that most successful campaign to the contacts that didn't open the first one. If you're a blogger, RSS feeds is going to be super helpful as we can create automatic triggers that go out every single time you publish a new blog. Now, automations are more tailored to a journey that you're looking for the contact to take. I always encourage you to ask yourself, is this going to be a one-time send, or is there some path or journey that I'm looking for the contact to go on while they're receiving this campaign? If the answer is the latter, then you absolutely want to use automations. You can think about them as nurturing for a pre-sale, pushing them towards an upsell to make them an advocate for your business, checking in on things that you might need from them, or just seeing how they're feeling about their products. Once you start to think about your campaigns as actual series based on certain things that you're looking for the contact to achieve, it'll be really helpful for you to differentiate the ways in which you can have them work together to essentially affect your entire customer journey. Now that we've covered that, let's go ahead, dive into the platform, and we're going to build our first campaign together. Now that we're in the platform, what we can do is actually go straight to campaigns. Here you can see that we have several drafts that we've built out within our account and maybe are waiting to send until the appropriate time. What we want to do is start a campaign from scratch. We're going to type in our fall and Halloween newsletter. So we're going to send a one-time standard campaign to all of our contacts on our newsletter, letting them know about our new fall and Halloween line. We'll go ahead and press next, and it's going to ask us, who do we want to send this to? We'll select our list right here, and if we wanted to create a segment of this list, as if we were sending maybe to a specific group of contacts, we could do that here. For now, we're just going to send to our newsletter list, and we'll go ahead and press next. You can see that there's several different types of campaign templates that you can utilize at any given time. The opportunities here are based on templates that you may have created and saved in the past, ones that we offer for you, or building from scratch. If you want to build from scratch, you can select any of these options here. For today, what we're going to do is we're going to use our fall newsletter template. So we'll select use that template, and then we'll change some of the information here to reflect what we want for Boone's Bandanas. So now what we're going to do is we're going to say Happy Halloween and Fall. And we're going to use a personalization tag to actually take an opportunity to include our pet's name in the subject line. We'll say Happy Halloween and Fall pet's name and press continue. Now that we've established who the campaign is going to come from, what the template is going to look like, and what our subject line is, we can get to building. You can see here that we have several different text blocks that highlight things that we've used in the past. Now that we've created a new campaign, we can go ahead and enter and say whatever we want. Happy Halloween. Maybe we want to change the colors on here, make it look a little bit more Halloween themed, or maybe we just want to focus on it being a strictly fall campaign with the Halloween contest that we're going to offer. You can see that you have an opportunity to hover over anything, resize it as you see fit by simply clicking right here, and then taking your text boxes and entering in the information that you want. Again, since this is a previous campaign that we used for something for spring, we want to make sure that we walk through this and change the verbiage so that it reflects the campaign that we're looking to send here. What we're going to do is actually display exactly how you can use personalization tags. We'll say, what was your favorite activity this summer? We can enter in a personalization tag by clicking on our personalized button and entering pet's name. You can use personalization tags anywhere throughout your campaigns. We can also say something like, we know that your favorite activity is, and use our personalization tag that allows us to populate what our dog's favorite activity is. Is trick-or-treating one of them? Now, if we wanted to create some kind of contest where we had a submission of dog Halloween costumes, we could absolutely do that. We've now entered in everything that we want in our text box, and our next step is our call to action. Our call to action says, enter to win here, but you want to redirect to some kind of link. So here you see on the right-hand side that you can click on this gear and direct to the specific link that makes the most sense for you. For us, it's going to be boonsbandanas.com/contest. Now, by clicking on the link in this campaign, you're actually re-triggering or triggering for the first time your site tracking and dropping the cookie on the contact. Now, if there's other things that you want to add or drag into your campaign, you can absolutely do that here. If you wanted to drag in a video, you could just drag in and place it wherever you'd like, entering in the URL for the video. It wouldn't play in the email, but it would actually play as soon as the contact clicks on it. If you're looking to delete any kind of text box, you can do that here. Through our Shopify integration, we're using this product block to bring in the products from our Shopify store. Now that our campaign looks exactly how we want it to, we're actually going to come over here, click on the gear, and enter in our pre-header text. Enter to win your Halloween baskets today. Letting them know this is exactly what our email is about, maybe giving them some more incentive to open the campaign. Here we want them to reply to help@boonsbandanas, not our CEO Boone. And now that everything else is filled out, we can go ahead and press close. Some other things that are important to note on your campaign design page are going to be setting a theme, backgrounds, using any undo or previous versions of your campaign, which you can do right here or through this last change was saved. Here you can see previous versions of your campaign, revert back to that if you like it better, or see if anybody else made revisions in your campaign before you sent it out. Once you've polished it up and looked exactly how you want it to, you can go ahead and press next, and it's going to take us to our summary page. Our summary page is going to look like an overview of your campaign. It'll let you know, hey, this is your subject line and your pre-header text, who it's coming from, who, if anybody replies, it's going to, how many contacts you're sending to, the business address affiliated with your campaign, letting you know that your open and link tracking is turned on so that you can get wonderful open rates and click rates to track in your email performance, and then asking if you want to schedule it out. Please note that if you want to schedule your campaign to go out at a certain time, this time is specifically reflective of your time zone that the ActiveCampaign account you're using is set to. It will not reflect your contact's time zone. If you wanted to send something out that is reflective of your contact's time zone, you could do that through building a campaign in automations. Last but certainly not least, I highly recommend sending a test to yourself to check your work. Here you'll have an opportunity to review how your pictures and text boxes line up, if your spelling and grammar is okay, and if the links that you added, or the call to actions rather, check out and go to the right place. It's always best to send a test to yourself so that you know that your campaign is in tip-top shape for your contacts. Once you're ready to send, you can go ahead and press send now or save and exit and come back to your draft at a later time. Now that you've successfully built your campaign, we want to review some next steps. Things that you could do if you have questions regarding your campaign is sign up for our office hours. You can also join our community where you can learn from other customers just like you how they're building their campaigns. Also, go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Let's Learn videos on topics just like this related to ActiveCampaign. We wish you the best in building your campaigns and nothing but success within ActiveCampaign. Have a great day.